Energy prices are rising without a sign to stop. Many people see the way out in solar energy. But how profitable is it?
There's no power here. These are just wires, no power.
My name is Eiler and you're on PissedConsumer channel. In this video, we will find out how much it costs to install solar panels, what profit they give, and how state covers the part of its purchase.
Verifies claims that the government is giving away solar panels for free.
In the end of this video, we'll find out, are solar panels worth buying? Let's figure it out. How much does it cost? A lot. At first, it may seem that it is even too expensive. Before applying tax credits or any advantages that might be accessible where you live, the average cost of a household solar panel installation in 2022 varies between $18,000 and $20,000. The size, price, and efficiency will depend on the place of your residence and the amount of energy you want to get.
In my situation, we have the IQ7 Pluses that cannot produce more than 295 max.
It's clear that in sunny regions, you may need fewer batteries, and in cloudy ones, you'll need more to achieve the same effect. Of course, the cost of the solar panel will depend on its type and manufacturer. Let's analyze the most popular ones. Monocrystalline panels have the highest efficiency as well as the highest price. As a rule, they produce power from 360 to 370, and the price depends on the manufacturer. So, for example, Suntech panel will cost around $325. LG monocrystal is much more expensive, almost $541. An average option is Panasonic for almost $467. We should note that despite the high cost, monocrystalline batteries are the most common on the market because they show an average efficiency of 22 to 27%. Polycrystalline batteries, for example, produce around 20% and they're also cheaper. Such a Suntech panel will cost only $175.05. Thin film solar panels are the most mysterious but portable. They have lower power and relatively high price, $280 for one BougeRV panel, but they weigh little and are very portable. Of course, it is worth doing a little research and paying attention to other users' review before making a decision. You may find a lot of reviews on solar panels on PissedConsumer.com. For example, in a video interview, our user recommends to refrain from buying Palmetto solar panels.
Hello, my name is Alma here from Pennsylvania, and I recently made the move to change to solar. Unfortunately, the company I use, Palmetto Solar, they promised me something. Unfortunately, they didn't deliver correctly the way they're supposed to. They promised me to install a system that were going to offset my energy by 110%, but now I found out that it's only 10%. Now I end up with a big loan and still getting high bills from the utility company. My advice is stay away from them as much as you can.
The majority of governments offer financial incentives to citizens who install solar panels on their homes.
To a working class family, stretching that dollar that they might have been paying for an electric bill, that can go towards savings for retirement, a better car, just a tank of gas, college tuition, whatever working class families need.
By using solar energy to meet the majority of your daily needs, you may take advantage of 30% tax credit. If you use solar power in addition to your conventional electricity sources, you may significantly lower your overall electricity costs. Furthermore, as the technology develops, there may be opportunities to offset electricity costs by contributing excess power to the grid. The main factor when deciding if solar panels are worth the cost is your electricity bills. There are many reasons why utility bills keep going up, and the majority of them are out of your control. Sounds good. But there are also cons. The initial expense is the biggest disadvantage. Even with a sharp decline in price recently, for an average household, they are still extremely expensive to buy and install. Batteries can store solar energy generated during the day to use at night, but stronger and more affordable batteries are required for this to be viable.
All right, so we're putting 2,300 watts coming in from our solar panels. You can see these little bubbles moving. That's showing you the way that power is flowing.
Batteries for off-grid residential use are unusual for residences that are connected to electricity grid, despite the fact that the prices for batteries that can be put to such use are falling and the capacity is rising. Additionally, solar panel installation may not be beneficial for households with insufficient amount of sunlight per year. It's possible that the residents of places with latitude far from equator don't receive enough sunlight for installation expenses to see a noticeable return on investment. Similarly to this, areas with a high proportion of overcast or rainy days won't receive enough sunlight to produce an adequate electricity. Generally speaking, gloomy or rainy day can significantly lower panel output by up to 90%. The 4 to 5 hours around midday, when the sun is at its strongest, are ideal for solar panel operation. Early in the morning and late in the evening, power output dramatically decreases. Even the most effective panels need significant space and coverage to produce electricity. Unfortunately, this fact limits the adoption of solar to candidates that have residences that have an access to the necessary square meters. So are solar panels worth it? Definitely yes, if you live in a sunny region. We should also take into consideration the lifespan of solar batteries. Most manufacturers give a 25-year warranty. However, according to study by National Renewable Energy Laboratory, up to 75% of the systems exceeded their warranty period. In addition, there is a nice bonus in strengthening the roof itself. According to a study by the UC San Diego School of Engineering, solar panels do appear to reduce the heat on building's roof or ceiling. The panels act as a roof shade, preventing the sun hitting the roof directly and leaving the gap between panels and roof where the wind can disperse any hot air produced. To sum up, we can say that due to the global increase in energy prices and the development of technologies, solar panels are good but expensive investment, which in the long term will help you to save a lot. Well, that's all for now. Thanks for watching this video. If you find this video helpful, don't hesitate to hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and write in the comments your opinion on solar batteries. Also, if you like what we do, you can help us with some donation. The link you will find in the description. Have a nice day.